Hello friends, my name is Karan Thakur and welcome to my channel Karan's Kitchen. Today I am going to show you how to fry Bombay duck or bombil as known in the regional language of Maharashtra. So I would like to apologize to all of you that I have not posted for since a long time, but I promise that I would be regular now. So here I have taken 10 to 12 Bombay ducks which are cut, chopped and well soaked in turmeric. Here I have kept one Bombay duck full to show you how to cut it. Then we have semolina or rava in the regional language which we will use for frying the Bombay duck. Then we have green chili paste, we have salt approximately 2.5 teaspoons, we have red chili powder approximately 1 teaspoon, we have turmeric powder 1/4 teaspoon, we have garam masala powder or allspice 2 teaspoons. We have oil for frying as required. Now let's start. So here I have taken the bombil or the Bombay duck. For first step you do is trim off the feathers lying over there. It's a little tricky because it slips. So after you have trimmed, you have to trim all the feathers from the body of the Bombay duck. Then you have to cut the Bombay duck in half. Then you will see, forgive me guys, this one feather was there on. Then you will see that there is a line. Then chuck the point of your knife in the line and slice the Bombay duck like this and open it up. Then repeat with another half, slice and chuck and see if it is done. You can just do it like this with your hands, but make sure it is flattened or it will be raw when we fry it. Chopped all the 10 to 12 Bombay duck pieces like this because I had to show you how to trim it, just I have kept it for the sake. Then I had chopped all the pieces like this and then I had washed them once in 1/4 teaspoon of turmeric and 1 teaspoon of salt. What does this step do is make them tender while frying, so it will bring a nice feel, it will be crispy in your mouth, and we will proceed further. So here are the Bombay ducks which are soaked for approximately 10 minutes in the water. Now we will chuck it them all in the plate. Then we will add the green chili paste to it. Then we will add the turmeric or haldi. Should waste nothing guys, just scrape the bowl. Then we will add the salt. And it's not required that the salt I am showing now. You add that much only. You add according to your taste. In our house, people like non-vegetarian dishes, really salty and tangy. So I am putting it. Then add the chili powder. Then add the allspice powder. After adding all this, just go in with your clean hands and mix them all. Make sure that every spice is coating every piece of the Bombay duck or the bombil. Now we have to mix it thoroughly for about 1 and 2 minutes. You have to just rub it on the fish like you are giving massage. If you want, you can add a little lemon juice over here, but I am not adding it now. I will add after it is fried, because if I add it now, the pieces will break while frying. So after massaging for about 30 seconds, I am going to keep it aside for 10 to 20 minutes to marinate really well. And then I will come back to you and show you how to fry it perfectly. Hmm. So here I am back after 20 minutes. This fish pieces has really marinated in the fridge. I have kept it in the fridge for over 20 minutes. It will give more better result if kept overnight in the fridge. Now we will fry it. For frying it, very first thing you need to do is add some oil to the tawa or the hot plate. Make sure the oil is going everywhere, because then the pieces won't be fried crispy. Then what you do is simply pick up a piece of, drench all the masala over it, dip it in the semolina from both the sides, give a double coat of semolina, because it is so soft and it has a risk of breaking while frying. And once your oil is hot, add it. It should bubble when added to the oil. If you add to the cold oil, it will not fry as fast as wanted. Then pick up another piece, rub it into some semolina again, give it a double coat and place it over. Then while frying, you take some oil and drizzle it over the pieces of the Bombay duck and let it fry for about 2 minutes on each side. So now it is about 1.5 minutes and these pieces are frying. This looks a little bit firm on the top, so I am going to turn it now. You simply lift up the piece with a flat spoon and turn it. See, it is fried. And when you rub your flat spoon, the voice should come to you of crackiness. It's a little bit tricky. So you turn. And now let this fry for another 1.5 minutes. Okay. So I have fried it on either side for 1.5 minutes as well. Now I am going to take them off of the hot plate or the tawa. Very tricky, guys. So here we have fried 2 pieces of Bombay duck. This looks very yummy and makes for a perfect Sunday. Stay tuned for more videos. Please do like, share, comment and subscribe on this video. And please do demand your recipes. I will try to fulfill them for today. Bye bye.